Hello everyone, myself Sneha Shinde, lecturer in Pravin Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology from Electrical Department. Subject is Utilization of Electrical Energy, Subject Code 22626, Unit 2, Electric Heating and Welding System. So now we will study arc heating. So the heat energy of electric arc, it utilize for heating. So the arc furnace for melting ferrous and non-ferrous materials, a high temperature is required, 3000 degrees Celsius to 3500 degrees Celsius, which is achieved by electric arc furnace. So the method of striking the arc is HT strike and the LT strike. So in the HT strike, in this method, a constant air gap is maintained between the two electrodes which are connected to the secondary of the step-up transformer by gradually increasing the primary voltage with the help of potential divider. Arc is made to strike between two electrodes. The arc is struck when voltage across the section is sufficient to ionize the air gap between the electrode. So the main component is the auto transformer and the step up transformer, where the primary side is the LT side and the secondary side is the HT side, and the electrode constant air gap it is maintained and the arc is allowed to strike between it. So the next type is the LT strike. In this method, the electrodes are connected across LV side of the transformer. First, they are shorted and then immediately separated, resulting in the production of the arc. This method is widely used in the different arc furnaces. Direct arc furnace. So here is the diagram of the direct arc furnace, where it is a single phase and here is the three phase. Okay. In single phase supply, two electrodes are used, where one is the phase and other is the neutral. And in the three phase furnace, the three electrodes are used, which are R, Y and P. So the arc is formed between the electrode and the charge. Construction. It consists of the arc chamber with the refractory lining. The total structure is supported on the metal framework and the carbon or the graphite electrodes are used. So here is the operation, that first the electrode is lowered and then separated from the charge. An arc gets struck and a very thin, very high temperature is produced. Arc is maintained due to ionization of air. Ionized air acts as a conductor. Current passing through the charge causes heating of the charge. Temperature of the arc is between 3000 degrees Celsius to 3500 degrees Celsius. But losses take place and actual temperature obtained is 1500 degrees Celsius to 2000 degrees Celsius. Now the application of direct arc furnace is, the main application is found in the production of the steel. The steel obtained by this method is more pure than the other method. And the non-conducting bottom type direct arc furnace or the submerged furnace. This furnace is used for ferroalloys. Electrodes are submerged in the charge flows current is proportional to the resistance offered by the charge. The steering arrangement is also provided. So in the indirect arc furnace, or we can say the rocking furnace, the construction is graphite electrodes are projected from side walls. These electrodes are at a certain height from the charge and the separate steering arrangement it is provided. So the operation of the indirect arc furnace is single phase AC supply is applied across the electrodes. The arc is struck by separating the electrodes manually or automatically. The heat is transferred to the charge top layer and a refractory lining through the radiation and from the top layer of the charge to other portion of the charge through the conduction. To distribute the heat uniformly, the furnace is rocked continuously. This type of construction limits the number of electrodes to 2, and therefore this furnace is available for single phase supply only, and the capacity of the furnace is limited to 1.5 tons only, and it is used for melting non-ferrous materials. And the electrode used for the arc furnace is carbon and graphite. And the properties of the carbon and graphite, as we have discussed early, that it should be infusibility, good electrical conductivity, insolubility, chemical inertness, mechanical strength, resistance to the thermal shock. So the basic arrangement is the electrodes and the phase and neutral supply and the rocking wheels where the charges get rolled. Here is a difference between direct arc furnace and the indirect arc furnace. So the temperature is high and the indirect arc furnace temperature is less. The size is more in direct arc furnace, where the size in indirect arc furnace is less. Applications are for the direct arc furnace used for continuous and large production of high quality steel and for ferromagnetic alloy, ferroalloy manufacturing. And the application of the indirect arc furnace is, it is suitable for melting non-ferrous metals for copper, brass, bronze, gunmetal, and the power requirement is less, and here the power requirement is more. So here is the difference between AC welding and DC welding. For the welding, the supply equipment used is welding transformer, and for DC welding, the DC differential compound generator or rectifier is used. So the efficiency of AC welding is high, that is 85%, and low is for DC welding, that is 65%. Cost is low and high. No load voltage is 72 to 100 volt, and here 50 to 60 volt, and the heating is non-uniform, and in the DC welding heating is the uniform. Arc stability is obtained from use of series reactor, less arc or less arc stability. In the DC welding, the DC differential component generator has the dropping characteristics or the Moore arc stability. Next heating is the induction heating. So, principle of electromagnetic induction is used for heating the charge. The heat energy is transferred to the charge at extremely rapid rate, much faster than other conventional methods. This is because heat is developed within the charge and whole resistance of the charge is utilized to produce the heat. The heat is generated within the charge without any physical contact between the source and the charge. The medium of energy transfer is the electromagnetic field. So in the induction heating, there are two types of the induction furnace. First is the core type induction furnace and second is the coreless induction furnace. So in the core type induction furnace, it consists of magnetic core having thin laminations of the silicon steel. The primary is wound on one limb and a crucible type non-conducting ring is provided on the secondary. The crucible provides housing for the metal to be heated. The crucible is made up of ceramic material so that it can withstand high temperatures. The core of the transformer is designed such that it does not saturate even if the high current is passed. So the operation of the core type induction furnace is, first of all the charge in the form of different size is poured into the crucible. Due to this different sizes of the material, there is a possibility that the secondary circuit may not complete. To avoid it, this is more conductive material of powder form is put on the pieces of the material. When AC supply is given to the primary, alternating flux is produced which links with the secondary. So EMF is induced in the charge itself. Heavy current is circulated through the top powder layer of a conductive material and a heat is produced in the top layer of charge which is transferred to the bottom layer of the charge. So disadvantages due to the irregular shape of the charge, magnetic coupling between primary and secondary is poor and the high leakage reactance due to the poor magnetic coupling causes poor power factor. Third is to avoid the low power factor, low frequency supply is necessary. So low frequency generator is required to be installed. The overall cost of the furnace is increased. Pinch effect may occur which causes open circuit to the secondary side. Crucible is of odd shape and it is difficult to manufacture. The pinch effect is the magnetic coupling between primary and secondary is very poor, resulting in the high leakage reactance and low power factor. To overcome this difficulty is kept small. The electromagnetic forces produce turbulence of the molten metal. This turbulent effect is dependent on the frequency and current density. The turbulence effect is severe at high values of the frequency and current density. Thank you.